European market for Monday the 21st of March 2011. Welcome to FX Bootcamp, non-alert service. I'm not going to make any direct trade recommendations during the course of the day. What I will do is conduct some live fundamental technical analysis. So then, like it all, we can put together some decently profitable trade plans. Please keep in mind, trading heavily leveraged is risky business, particularly when leverage 50 to 1, sometimes more. So please not trade that hard in money until you have a track record of success using your broker's PlayPlay demo account. Okay, guys, well, so it happened. Busy week last week. You know, little yen intervention and bottomed out and rose and all kinds of different things. Today, I think, you know, I'll keep you updated on what I think of the yen through my Twitter as the day goes on. But I'd like to take a look at the Aussie. Yeah, Aussie looks interesting. So let's have a look. Okay, now this is a classic case of sort of daily downtrend meets 4-hour uptrend. Okay, take note here on the Aussie dollar how, you know, you sort of bottomed down in these mid-96s. Made a little higher low, higher higher scenario. So you've actually got yourself a short-term little 4-hour uptrend. Okay, however, if I show you the daily chart here, all right, let's let this update. Now, Aussie on this particular broker, we haven't opened on this particular broker yet, but I'm looking at some others, and we actually did push down a little bit from where we are. Not surprising, considering the fact that we opened at resistance effectively. But you know, you can see here on the daily the brand new change of trend. So what I'm actually expecting is a little something like this. You know, up, you know, hiccup here, a little higher low, and then we actually try and continue to the short side, a little something along those lines, right? A quick look at the weekly chart. I don't want to spend much time here. there's a weekly, a bit of a, you know, obviously a wicked little Bollinger Band bounce, but I still think, you know, I'm not sure we're going to make lower lows, but I still think that we can, you know, push this candle. See, I want red on that. I still think that we can sort of push this next candle down through that 21 EMA a little bit, and then we'll have to take some inventory on where we are. So that's more or less the sort of price action I'm expecting on this weekly chart. All right, and then I think a lot of people are targeting sort of these swing highs. I actually had 96 in mind as a target. If you take this little trap projection here, you know, if you take this and count that as a break, in which case you're going to take this perpendicular measurement, you almost get 96 figure on that. So, you know, call it 95, however you have it measured. But I had sort of 96 in mind. By that time, this 55 EMA is going to have moved up to that level, and I expect a considerable bounce there. Anyway, nonetheless, nobody really cares about the old weekly chart, but we'll have a look here. So what I'm trying to say, though, okay, so we open, we push down a little bit, but how I see this is that this is a red zone. What I mean by that is it's a good sell zone here. If we're going to push down, this would be the zone I expect. You've got parity right above you, all right? You've got these previous swing lows, this range area. Look at all the price action in this zone. So it wouldn't be surprising for us to drop 100 pips to 98. Okay, now I do think, though, because you've got a 4-hour uptrend meets daily downtrend, you are going to have some bias. So this is what I'm expecting here. All right, let me scroll over on this 4-hour. Okay, so ultimately what I'm expecting is this. We come off the resistance a little bit. All right, let me get my pen going. We come off the resistance a little bit. We push down to around this 99.40 area. Okay, and then we actually try and push up more towards 99.80 and parity. But at that point, I'm looking for a 15-minute change of trend that takes us back down to 99 today. All right, so that's my little trade plan for the Aussie dollar, is a long before a short. Okay, so how's that gonna look? Here's your hourly chart. Let me push you over here a little bit. There it is. So what I'm expecting is a little something like this. All right, open up, push down to 40, and kick up a little bit towards that 99.80 to parity mark, and then we try and short all the way back down to where you know, this 21 EMA is obviously going to be tough, plus this previous high around the 99.50, but I think that we'll lower high off that and continue short to around 99. At that point, I think the Aussie is actually going to be quite tough, because then you're going to have daily downtrend meets 4-hour uptrend and the whole thing. All right, but this is something we can make money out of. The long and most notably the short, particularly if we're around the market open London-wise, at that parity mark, I really think it's a decent short. And, you know, if it breaks sort of 10.30, we're wrong. But that's what I'm looking for, short around 99.80 to parity mark, trying to take it down 100. Okay, you know, also keep an eye out for these yens. I think that the couple of interesting charts there, you know, is this intervention going to have a lasting effect? You know, 80 is a big level on the yen for that, and something like 130 on the pound yen and some other things. You know, if we're going to see continuations up to the long side, it would be a reasonable expectation that 130 would be the mark and 80 would be the mark there to see how far we go. So sorry, I'm not showing you the charts, I'm just sort of talking about it. But yeah, big day today. Now, from my perspective, intervention has always been a bit of a failed policy. But as was announced last Thursday, Friday, I mean, this is a cascading intervention. I mean, have you ever heard anything? could they make it more dramatized? Anyway, so we'll see, right? If it's a cohesive effort from multiple central banks, it might actually have some gusto to it. But typically, intervention is a bit of a failed policy. So we have to see how the market reacts to these things. But let's trade it technically and go from there, okay? My name is David Pegler. Look at the European market for March 21st, 2011. Take it easy, everybody, and we'll talk to you tomorrow. Cheers.